Well, my parents, they're really humble people, so they didn't put any pressure on me to become a footballer or anything. They wanted me to study a lot, you know, as normal parents would do. And they just taught me good morals, you know, and I think that really humbles you and wants you to, you know, try and work hard for the best. I'm Yunus Musah and I play for Valencia and the US national team. My earliest memories in football, they were in Italy when I was playing with my brother and his friends. They were much older than me, so yeah, I think that helped me. And I just loved it. We played outside so much, for so many hours in the park next to my house. I've lived in a lot of countries and that's allowed me to become a citizen of them. Obviously, my parents are from Ghana. My dad was in Italy working, then got married in Ghana and took my mom to Italy with him. Then my mom just went to USA to visit my uncle for a while and while she was pregnant. So that's how I was born there. So we live in Italy though. Stayed there for a few years. And then, yeah, it was a shaky period in Italy, you know. And my dad just wanted a fresh start somewhere. And went to UK. It was like, yeah, he just told us we're going. Obviously him and my mum knew, but to us, me and my brothers, it was like, yeah, like we didn't want to go, you know. We've just known Italy all our lives. We're like, no. He knew that turned out to be great, you know. Got into Arsenal, like, I was playing for a local team. I played like 2 matches and then a scout came and watched me. Stayed there for a few years. And then at the end of my time at Arsenal, I felt that it was the best thing to come to Valencia. That this offered me such a great project. I'm playing in the first team now at a young age, so it's paid off. I thought, yeah, whatever happens, I'm going to make sure it works. And thank God it happened like that. And yeah, that's been the journey. I've played with England in the national, in the youth. You know, I've played for them since under 15s. Been to almost every camp. So it was a great experience. But then ultimately, for my career, I thought that playing for the US was the best decision.
The future is us.
I was speaking to the manager a lot and then they took me to the camp. I met everyone, the staff, the players, and it just felt really good, you know. I'm a person that goes really with my gut and with what I see, and I felt that this was the best step for my career. It felt hard to leave from a setup that helped me up so much, you know. But at the end of the day, like I've done with a lot of decisions in my short life so far, I've said to myself, like, if I go for it, I'm gonna, no matter what, I'm gonna stick to it and make it work, you know, in the bad times and in the good times. And I think that helps me with my decisions. As a player, I think physically I've been good. So I can take people on and like shove them around and stuff. I think that helps to have that physical advantage. So then I really had to work on my technical side. And yeah, I'm still working on it, And I think my teammates at Arsenal and Valencia could see that I always had this mindset to always try and improve and be the best. I like to be a box-to-box midfielder, you know, defend and attack, you know, and do everything. I think my teammates would agree I'm easy to work with. I'm always there trying to give my best, help everyone. I'm nice to everyone, you know, and I think everyone could talk to me and stuff. And I think it's just nice to have someone like that, I think. And that helps you with football as well, you know. You end up having fun together. I always thought, like, whoever's giving me advice, I'm going to listen to it, you know. Coaches, my parents, teachers, other parents, because ultimately it could help you. So, yeah, I'd say if you want something, I really stick to it and go for it. And just make sure you enjoy it, because if you don't enjoy it, you're not going to work so hard at it and try and be the best at it. When things are not going right, don't be too down. You know, it's not the end of the world. And when you're doing really well, don't get too carried away as well. So there's a balance. And also, I'd say you need to set yourself short-term goals and long-term goals. And the short-term goals are like the ones where help more, I think, to get to the long-term ones. So, you know, every day in training, improve bit by bit, you know, listen to the coaches, listen to what they're saying, watch your matches back, and that those little details help a lot to reach your long-term goals, you know. And ultimately, I want to become one of the best players in the world, playing on the big stage, in the Champions League, the World Cups, and winning them ultimately. So yeah, that's what I want to do.